Hey there. Welcome to Toy Talk with Mike and Chad, episode 15. I'm Mike.
I'm Chad.
And today, we're actually not going to talk about any toys on Toy Talk. We have toys we could talk about, but we'll save those for another day. This will hopefully be a short episode. Do you want to do, like, light spoiler, spoiler-free, full spoiler?
I feel like we should do spoiler-free, just because it technically doesn't release until tomorrow.
Okay. Like, it is Thursday night. We just got out of seeing Black Adam. And, we're going to talk about our initial reactions. We actually got out of the movie like half an hour ago now.
Yeah.
And we haven't...
We haven't spoken about it at all yet, so...
Yeah, we just walked out of the theater in silence, drove back here, and grabbed a beer, and now we'll talk about it. So... I'll say
as spoiler-free
as spoiler-free as we can get. We won't ruin any major like plot points and stuff. Try and talk about maybe things you know from the trailers and things like that.
I think most of the stuff is common knowledge about the movie in general. So
yeah,
if we can keep it to that, that should be okay.
All right, so let's first talk about our expectations going in. So me personally, I wasn't even really going to see this in the theater.
Yeah.
I have been... very unimpressed with the DC universe. I thought it started off really bad with Man of Steel, which I do not like. Some of the other... I find Batman, Superman, Wonder Woman, Justice League, all decent. You know, I enjoy elements of them. But I thought Wonder Woman 2 was terrible. I didn't care for Shazam. Aquaman I thought was pretty dumb. And Black Adam is a character I have zero attachment to. I've never read a Black Adam comic book. I'm not like a diehard Rock fan either. So when this was announced, I was like, I don't think I'm giving DC any more of my money. I'm not going to go. Regular viewers know that Chad is a big DC guy, though. So he asked me if I would go with him opening night. So I said, all right. Like, I'm not that opposed, but I probably wouldn't have went otherwise. My expectations were low.
I was kind of mixed. So Rotten Tomatoes gave it crappy reviews. IGN gave it a 5 out of 10. They shit-talked it quite a bit and said that it was flat. The storyline was kind of all over the place. For me, Mike did say that I'm the DC guy. I've never gotten into the Black Adam comic books, but I do know about the character. I know this was a project 15 years in the making because Dwayne Johnson was originally cast as Black Adam back in 2007. He went through a lot of delays and shooting issues and trying to get a script. That aside... I didn't really have high expectations for it, but I didn't have low either. I just wanted to kind of see the movie because it's been so long and I've been waiting like other fans. Would I go see it again? Probably not. I don't think it was terrible, but I don't think it was...
So is it better or worse than you expected?
Based on the reviews, I think it's better than I expected. Like I said, my hopes were kind of low when we were chatting about that last night a bit. And, you know, I wasn't really expecting much. I knew there was going to be a lot of action. The characters in it, you know, they were okay. That was my initial thought.
Yeah. And by just rhyming off all the DC movies... I actually forgot the biggest offender was probably the first Suicide Squad and the Birds of Prey
movies. Yeah, okay, yeah.
I liked the third Suicide Squad by James Gunn, but those first two were such a clusterfuck of a movie. Like, I hated Suicide Squad. Yeah. That was worse than Man of Steel. That was just a waste of my time and my money. And I was thinking this could potentially fall into that... low of a category, just because, again, like, it's a character that nobody really cares about. Like, there might be a one or two big, huge Black Adam fans, but, like, he's never been a character that's been able to maintain his own book or anything like that. So, he's not that interesting of a character. They've got a lot of other, you know, too many characters.
Yeah.
Like, I can understand them maybe for the, you know, the second movie or the third movie, bringing in all these other new characters like Hawkman and Dr. Fate and Atom Smasher. But
Cyclone,
and it goes on. But they, when I saw these trailers, and I'm like, they're trying to do that thing again where they're trying to catch up to Marvel.
Yeah.
And they're trying to cram six movies into one, and it's going to be an incoherent mess, and none of these characters are going to be done justice. And I did want it to be that bad, obviously. I don't want any of these movies to be that bad. I feel there's a lot of internet reviewers that, like, choose a side, and then they wish all the Marvel movies are garbage and they want them to bomb, and some people want all the DC movies to bomb. I want them all to be good. I'd love to love all of these movies. This was not an abomination. I actually, my initial reaction, and it changed a couple times during the movie.
Yeah.
I liked it. And I'm genuinely shocked that I liked it. I didn't love it. It's definitely got a lot of problems. Mm-hmm. But I was entertained. I enjoyed it.
So I think we're kind of on the same page with that one, because like, all the characters that are in this movie, like you mentioned, Hawkman, Cyclone, Atom Smasher, Dr. Fate, they're the Justice Society of America. So they're the JSA. So that's common knowledge out there. I wish that they either would have done a JSA movie beforehand, or let Black Adam have its own movie and then do a JSA movie afterwards, because you're exactly right. They're trying to cram too much stuff in there. Action-wise, it was full of action. It was good. But I definitely had some of the same lulls that you did in between certain sequences, and, you know, I was kind of on the fence about it, but overall, I'm walking away, you know, happy, but I probably wouldn't pay to go see it again.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think I'd see it again in the theater, but I might actually buy the Blu-ray if there's enough bonus features or director's commentary. Like, it's worth revisiting. Partly because, how long was it?
It was 2 hours and 4 minutes.
Okay. So it wasn't overly bloated like some of these movies get to be. Like, I liked Justice League, the Snyder Cut, but 4 hours is like, it makes it very hard to rewatch. It's too much. And even these movies that teeter on 3 hours and stuff, it's like, get over yourself. So to come in at 2 hours, you know, a reasonable length. As far as the action goes, there was a ton of action. Almost to the detriment of the film, I thought it was almost too much action. I kind of felt like there's the setup, which you've seen in the trailer, and then The Rock shows up and he's, you know, he's breaking missiles with his hands and he's kicking ass and he's knocking down helicopters. But then I feel like from that scene continued almost right to the end of the movie.
Yeah.
Like, I felt like no time passed. I felt like this whole movie might have taken place in a half an hour. Like, and it takes away from the weight of everything. Like, how dangerous is this bad guy if he can be disposed of within, you know, the 2 hour time frame? And the 2 hour time frame almost felt like real time. And how you know, how is the world gonna respond to Black Adam when we've only known him for this short time? The fact that the Justice Society had to react, and like, love interests were formed, and things happened, and all these relationships changed, and people like that didn't trust each other start trusting each other, and it's like, this is happening in a very short period of time. So, well,
And I think, like, the citizens of his town, they knew more about him than anyone else. And they were like, yeah, it's this guy. And, like, the story was kind of lacking in certain places. Definitely. And I agree with you that it kind of felt like it was taking place in a very short amount of time to build that trust. Certain characters, I didn't particularly like Atom Smasher. I thought he was kind of a wiener, like a doofus.
He looked like Deadpool.
Yeah, it's just gave me that vibe.
The way they CG'd him, and even the texture on his costume, it basically looked like Deadpool recolored, like And even the fact that he was kind of the comic relief, it felt like they were leaning into, look, we have a Deadpool too. Yeah. Which it might have, even if he looked like Deadpool, but they made him, like, say, serious, then it might have been, okay, felt a little different. But I was like, yeah, this feels like a Deadpool knockoff for sure. Having said that, I didn't mind him, though. Again, I was surprised, as far as the Justice Society goes, I liked them all. Mm-hmm. And, like, you said you think they should have done one of those movies first. I don't know if anybody would have went to see that movie if they saw these four characters and they tried to make a movie about it. Well, yeah.
DC fans might have.
But I totally would go see their movie now.
Yeah.
Like, I thought they were all interesting. Some of them had less to do than others. But they didn't, the ones that didn't do much, they didn't hype them up. Like, if you watch the Joss Whedon Justice League, you know, they recruit the Flash, they make him seem super powerful, but then when the grand finale happens, he has, like, nothing to do.
Yeah.
But, like, Hawkman and Dr. Fate are obviously the big players, and I felt like they really got their due. You felt like you followed their arc, you cared about them, they got enough time in the spotlight. The other two, less so, but they kind of had their own little thing, and they didn't make us think, like, oh, they needed to do something epic. They were kind of there as backup, and that's what they did. I was very pleased with those, with the Justice Society characters.
I was impressed with Hawkman. Specifically because I know a little bit about him. I don't know too much. I haven't read any of his books or anything. No. Character-wise, he looked kind of dumb in the action figure, and I was like, this is... But actually seeing him on the screen... Same with Cyclone. I didn't buy the Cyclone figure. I'm going to have to pick it up now. Same with the Sabic figure. The only thing that I thought was very rushed was at the end. So, Sabic was only on screen for, what, like 25 minutes out of the whole movie?
Yeah.
So, it kind of... You could tell it was coming. They definitely built it up, but I don't think he had enough screen time.
Well, like, as far as Hawkman goes, he's a character that I don't know much about. I've never really read his comic books. I read Hawk Girl for a while. But I always liked the look of Hawkman. Mm-hmm. And I was disappointed when I saw what they did to him. We talked about it an episode a while back, about how he was wearing all brown.
Yeah.
He looked very drab. And I was like, man, they took a really cool-looking character and they made him dull. But seeing the movie,
it worked.
I thought he looked great. I think he could hold his own movie if they spun it off. And Pierce Brosnan is Dr. Fate.
Fantastic.
And I didn't buy his figure. I've always liked Dr. Fate, too. I don't know much about him. I always thought he looked really cool. But when I saw the new version of him, I'm like, why did they take the eyes off his helmet? It looks so dumb. But it looked cool.
Yeah.
In the movie, it worked. That I'm kind of tempted to go buy both Hawkman and Dr. Fate.
I know. I have a Dr. Fate figure, but it's not the Black Adam one. I very rarely buy duplicates, so I'm going to probably have to get that one, too. I do like how they kind of CGI'd his eyes in, though. It was like the glowing kind of white.
I think we only saw that in like near the end, right?
Yeah.
But it gave me promise of like, oh, cool.
Yeah.
I kind of wish they had done that through the whole movie. Because I do think it looked cool when you saw the glowing that represented the eyes. But it didn't look as bad without the... It made him look more alien, not having the eyes. And I think it kind of worked. Regarding Atom Smasher, we talked about it when you bought these figures. And you bought the small one. And I said, you should have bought the big one. Do you have any thoughts on that now?
Yeah, I'm going to have to buy the big one.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, I don't usually buy duplicates of figures, but I don't know. As much as I shit on him, I do like his ability. I think it's kind of cool, and he did have a lot of very nice action sequences where he held his own. Character-wise, though, like I feel like he was just there for comic relief, and
yeah.
I didn't really bond with him.
One thing, and this isn't necessarily even a criticism. Like, Marvel and DC have so many, like, echoes of characters. And, you know, you've got a Superman in DC. Well, you've got a version of him in Marvel. You've got a Spider-Man in Marvel. You've got a kind of a variation of him in DC. But I feel for movies, audiences that aren't used to that or just accept that to be fact. I wonder if there's going to be like a been there, done that feel to a lot of these guys. Like seeing Adam Smasher grow, is it just going to be like, oh, he's like Ant-Man
yeah.
in the Marvel movies. And that line in Civil War that get a big laugh is when he's like, does anybody have any orange slices? Like he needs food because growing takes up his yeah. energy. And it was a like a visual gag in this movie that after he grew, you'd see Adam Smasher like eating a bucket of chicken yeah. or eating something. And again, it almost felt like a little derivative of that. Same as Dr. Fate. He was when he did his magic and the world kind of went into like mirror reflections, almost like a stained glass. It felt very Doctor Strange when he goes into the mirror universe yeah. or whatever he calls it. So it's almost a shame that these filmmakers put a lot of effort to make it look cool. But like, yeah, we saw that last year, you know, so. Hmm. But the effects, for the most part, were cool. There were some sketchy ones, but I think for the most part, pretty well done.
The side characters too, they were kind of funny. They did add a lot of substance to the movie and like lack of story. Kind of drove that around. They had the DJ Khaled looking guy.
Yeah,
the electrician. He was kind of funny.
Yeah, I wasn't sure about him at first, but he did have some funny moments. Yeah,
he grows on you. But I don't know. I think it definitely had its hiccups, but overall, I'm happy with it. Would I give it a 5 out of 10 like the other reviewers did? Probably not. I might put it at like a 7.
Yeah, I'm around the same. I'd say a 7, which is, especially for these DC movies, mm-hmm. That's very good. It's much better than what
yeah.
I would give Suicide Squad a 0. I would give Man of Steel, even which I really didn't like, 2 or a 3.
Yeah, well, you really hate that.
Yeah, I really do.
Yeah.
Going back to Sabak,
I think is how they were saying it.
When I knew we were going to come home and talk about it on video, he was one of the things that I didn't know if I should talk about as a spoiler, but I had actually forgotten that he's in the toy line.
Yeah, he is.
So you should know he's going to be in the movie, but I, watching the movie, I completely forgot about mm-hmm. him. So when he showed up, I was like, oh shit, you know, like, who's this guy? The thing, I can't believe this made it all the way to the finished product. I think he was one of the weaker effects.
Yeah.
I don't think he looked great. But if you don't know who Sabak is, and I don't know him from the comic books, but he's a big devil-y guy. He's red. He's got horns. He's got a little goatee. Like, he's very traditional devil. But when he spoke, he was like, I'm going to get you,
yeah.
Black Adam. And I was like, this is the devil from South Park.
Yeah. Yeah.
He looks and talks just like
yeah.
him.
Yeah.
I just kept thinking he was going to say, I love you, Saddam, you know, and I was like, how did they not catch that? Like, they should either change his voice or change his look. Yeah, it made me laugh every time I saw him, and I think he was supposed to be the big, scary, bad guy, but I just couldn't help but snicker when he's on there, because he looks, it's like a live-action version of the South Park devil.
So, do you want to talk about spoilers? So,
well, hold on, is there, because we can put out, this is the line.
No, I won't spoil anything.
You won't spoil anything, okay.
So, within the last, like, week or so, it's been all over the internet, like, hey, Dwayne Johnson's, or spoilers are going out, and you're never going to guess who's providing them, and it was, like, Dwayne Johnson. So, I was like, okay, mental note, I'm going to stay away from any source of media whatsoever. One day, I'm scrolling through my Instagram, and I see a picture that Dwayne Johnson posts and read the caption and was like, motherfucker, are you serious? Because he spoiled something that I think is unforgivable. Because, I mean, it's not a major part of the story in this movie, but
yeah.
going forward, I think it definitely is.
He ruined the tag. I didn't know that. Chad told me that something had been spoiled for him by The Rock. And I said, well, don't tell me. And then as the movie ended, and I said, do you know if there's anything coming afterwards in the credits? And he said, yes. And I said, is this what was spoiled for you? And he said, yes. So that's disappointing to have the tag spoiled for you.
Yeah.
But at least it wasn't like necessarily the finale of the movie something like that.
And he has since gone back and deleted said picture. He probably got shit on by the studio.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think, it it's not important to this storyline, but going forward, it was just like, you know, you look forward to the end sequences and...
Yeah. And I was hoping I would like Hawkman and Dr. Fate because I like those characters. And I did. I did not expect, I had no expectation, even if I liked the movie, to like Black Adam. Mm-hmm. Because I don't think the character is interesting. He's part of the Shazam family, yeah. And I dislike mm-hmm. the Shazam characters. I don't think his costume is particularly interesting. And I don't want to say I'm not a fan of The Rock, but I don't really like Rock movies so much. I know they call him, like, what is the term they use? Like, you know, you bring him into a franchise to kind of revitalize
him. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And, you know, he was in G.I. Joe, Retaliation. I didn't dislike him in it, but, you know, I didn't need him there. I liked Black Adam in this movie. It's kind of how I want Namor to be in mm-hmm. in the Black Panther movie, and I don't think he's going to be that, just from the look of the actor they cast. Like, this was... Black Adam was so smug and kind of didn't care in this movie. Like, when he's just floating, and he's, like, just knocking walls over and stuff when he's floating along, I thought, like, yeah, this guy just doesn't give a shit. And I liked that character. I actually kind of want to go buy one of those Black Adam figures.
Yeah.
I think I would get the one with the hood.
Yeah, I think it's still on Amazon.
I like the one with the hood better. Yeah, I can't believe I actually liked that character as portrayed by The Rock.
So one of the other things, too, like, I'm kind of the opposite. I am a Dwayne Johnson fan. I like action movies, so... the only thing that bothered me about his Black Adam is that they didn't make it... comic book style enough. So Black Adam, I don't know if you know, he's got like a widow's peak and he's got pointy ears. None of that. And I mean,
very Namor-esque.
Yeah, it'd be a little weird seeing The Rock with hair after being bald, but at least give him the pointy ears. Also, he didn't have his cape for the majority of the movie.
Yeah.
And then the last like 15 minutes he gets his cape.
At least he was wearing, like, again, I'm not a fan, and he had at least his costume mm-hmm. on. This is a very, very mild spoiler. I don't think it really matters, but, like, he doesn't even go by the name Black Adam in the movie. It's literally kind of like...
Jeff Adam.
Yes, he has a name that's kind of his ancient name that he uses, and it's kind of just, like... Oh, like at sort of the end of the movie when they say, you know, why don't you pick a different name? He goes with Black Adam. You know, that's his name. And it's one of the things I find kind of annoying sometimes. This didn't really affect the story anyway. And at least they were calling him Adam throughout the movie. But when you go see something and there's no guarantee they're going to make a sequel. Like, I don't know how this will perform. It might very well bomb. Who knows? It's got terrible reviews, so it might tank. And then, so they set up all these things, and you kind of just make the character be the character at the end of the movie, and you're like, come back for the next one. And you're like, well, there might not be one. Mm-hmm. Like, that's how I felt with G.I. Joe, The Rise of Cobra. It's like, I'm a G.I. Joe fan. I want to see G.I. Joe fight Cobra. But instead, the whole movie is like setting up Cobra, and it's like the end of the movie, Cobra Commander's like, now I'm Cobra Commander. And you're like, and they're like, come back.
That was a really good impression.
Thank you. And they almost didn't make a sequel. Like, and when they did, it was almost a reboot.
Yeah.
And Snake Eyes, the solo Snake Eyes movie is another good example. He literally doesn't put on his Snake Eyes outfit until the last 30 seconds of the movie. He puts his mask on. He's like, okay, this was my origin. Now I'm Snake Eyes. Come back for the next one. But guess what? It tanked. We'll never see that Snake Eyes. Make the movie you're supposed to make. This one doesn't really fall into that category, but I just mean, like, when the character doesn't really put on his final costume and take his final name until the end of the movie, it's a little frustrating. This is a minor point in this movie, but it's major in some
other movies. And they didn't even say his name.
Yeah.
It only came out, like, after the credits. Well, he got addressed by Black Adam.
And correct me if I'm wrong. But in the Shazam movie, because that character's name is Captain Marvel.
Yeah.
But they couldn't call him that because of
Marvel
comics. But I don't think they referred to him as anything in that movie. Like,
just Billy Batson. They call like him Billy.
He says Shazam. And the movie's titled Shazam.
Yeah.
And it's kind of, a lot of people just assume that the character's name is Shazam. And I kind of wish they just said that in the movie. But they kind of spent the whole movie dodging calling him anything. Mm-hmm. And that annoys me. Like, just call him something.
I think that's still a point of contention for, like, DC fans. Because I know I still refer to him as Captain Marvel when I talk about him with comic book friends. But, like, the general public wouldn't know that. They'd know him as Shazam. So I think, you know, kind of leaving that sort of ambiguous throughout the whole movie. Again, like, does he have a name that he goes by? They settled on when Marvel had the rights for Captain Marvel, they were, like, scrambling, trying to figure out what to call him. They're like, let's just call him the word he says, Shazam. And, like, it's kind of loosey-goosey.
I liked how they handled it in the example that's coming to my mind right now, because I just watched it recently, is She-Hulk. Mm-hmm. It's like, it might seem silly for this character to take that name for herself. So I think they handled it in a good way. They're like, she's become a Hulk. And then she watched a news report, and they're like, now there's a She-Hulk roaming the streets. And then everybody just starts saying, who's the She-Hulk? And she's like, oh, well, I guess this, now I'm stuck She-Hulk. With this name now. Like, that should have been how they handled Shazam or something. Yeah. Is that, like, somebody hears them say, Shazam! And then they run off to a reporter, and they're like, yeah, this guy said Shazam and saved the day. And then the headline to read, who is Shazam? And, like, now he's Shazam. He didn't have to pick that name for himself. Maybe he really is Captain Marvel, but the public is referring to him, and the movie-going audience knows him now as Shazam. But just, like, give him a name. You can't have a whole movie with a character that doesn't have a name.
And it's weird, too, because I'm assuming that Shazam and Black Adam would potentially meet on screen at one point. And, how's that dynamic going to work?
Well, we could probably go down this DC wormhole forever. Yeah. But we're at a half hour. This doesn't have to be a super long episode. Is there anything more on Black Adam specifically we have to say?
I don't think so without spoiling a lot of it. So in that case, like, if you watch it, leave comments. Leave comments on the video.
What did you think?
I would definitely interact with those comments.
Since
DC seems to be my wheelhouse.
I know. We both gave it a thumbs up.
Yeah, I would do 7 out of 10 comfortably.
Yeah, 7 out of 10 is where I'm sitting too. It was kind of a nice surprise. I wish they kind of took a breath every now and again to let some time pass. Mm-hmm. Like, there's even a segment of the movie where Black Adam is kind of like out of commission.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh no, with him gone, the threat is rising. Oh, but he's back. And I felt like he was only gone for, like, 2-3 minutes.
Yeah.
But it felt like we were supposed to feel like he'd been gone a while. And we were supposed to be like, oh my God, I didn't know if we'd see him again. It's like, we barely got a chance to think he was, like, gone. And so it felt a little too condensed in that regard. Same as the set pieces. I felt like the whole movie took place in this one town square almost. Like, they never really ventured very far from the main. When the first battle takes place, that's kind of where they stay. Yeah. So I felt like the movie could have
expanded
into more areas, stretched out a longer period of time. Not literally, but just in the movie have more time pass. The devil, Sabak, I could have done without him. Now, mind you, without him, the ending would have been pretty unsatisfying. Because you do need a big bad for Black Adam to punch. But I would have rather another villain. That guy was not a good villain. I don't know. Still, 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10.
Thumbs up. I might go buy some of the figures.
Mission accomplished.
So there's the toy talk for the episode.
Yeah.
We might go buy more toys. Surprise, surprise. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this. This is the first time we've ever done a strictly movie review, I guess we sort of did here. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, let us know. I've kind of consciously made an effort not to review movies on this channel because I feel there's so many other movie reviews out there and we're not going to say anything that a million other people haven't already said on YouTube. But if you enjoy it, if you like hearing us talk about movies, let us know. Maybe we'll do more of them. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. Come back soon for more actual toy talk. Make sure to like and subscribe.
Leave us comments again.
Leave us comments. Okay, so we'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Ciao.
Keep collecting.